morning on the bushwalk, and I couldn't quite see them clearly from where we were, but now I can clearly see that it is Mr. and Mrs. Whiteface stuck with all their little chicks, all their little ducklings, not chicks. Isn't that nice? They were just hanging against the water's edge, but as soon as they feel as though a threat is near, and we apparently pose a threat to these ducks, they ushered their little ones away from the water's edge and to the middle, where they'll be much protected by the surrounding waters. There's very few things that would go charging into water unless they were absolutely starving, like a young leopard, to go in and try and catch something like that. But you can see they look nothing like the adults just yet. They haven't got the white face. They've still got to develop their adult coloration. There's one of the adults. See, keeping a close eye on either side of the chicks. Chicks in the middle, very much like how a herd of elephants puts their youngsters in the middle. Look at that. Just scouting about. And what you might find is that maybe that's the male that was off to the left, and that's mum with all the little ducklings. And if a threat does come by, she might swim away with them, and dad might stay behind and sort of make a lot of noise, maybe even peck them, try and mob them. I've seen some very angry Egyptian geese before protecting their young against water monitors. See there, because she's saying right now, come on, everyone, stay together, stay in line. Please hold hands. And off they go. Isn't that cool? They're beautiful, all the ducks in the row. Rachel, you said that they've got a bazillion chicks. They've definitely got a few. Let's count them. Can we start? Yes, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I think I counted correctly. I think there's 11 chicks. Let's keep an eye on them. Let me count them again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. No, no. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. That was terrible counting. 13, not 11. I missed two, apparently. We shall now try and keep an eye on the chicks, now that we know that there are actually 13 and not 11 of these ducklings. And let's see how many of them survive. The chances of them moving away from this pan is very slim. It's a good water source here. There's lots of food available for them. It's big. They'll feel safe, like we've just seen. They've ushered their little ones out into the middle. So I think it'll be a good spot. Unless the Egyptian geese come back and they're pretty territorial and chase everything else away, that might be the only thing that could get them to move. Otherwise, I reckon that we might watch these little ones reach adulthood too. But let's carry on. Let's continue towards the area where the alarm calls.